Hey girls, it's Sunday. Happy Sunday. It is Sunday, October 22nd. Welcome back to another regular Black Girl vlog. If you're returning, if this is your first time, thank you. Be sure to hit the subscribe button, like, comment, all that good stuff. I just left church. Such another good word. He ain't missed yet. Union Church of Charlotte. I've been talking about it on my vlog so far. It's good. My mom was supposed to be with me today and she told me she was up all night. So she didn't make it and I'm so sad because I think it was a word she would have enjoyed. But I'm just going to send her the YouTube link like I've been doing. And I'll be sure to drop it in the description box below for you guys as well. But I just wanted to open up the vlog. It's a new week. Sunday is a new day. Going over to my sister's house right now to just chill out with them for a little bit. My baby niece, Callie, is here for a couple hours. So I'm going to hang out with them, probably eat some dinner. My sister said she was gonna cook, and I ain't never passing up a Kendra meal if I can. She got delicious plates. But no, she even really throw down. We was joking about that the other day, like watching my grandma in the kitchen. I was there waiting in the kitchen. I wasn't watching, and I should have been watching because I can cook a little bit, but not like Kendra, not like Kendra. So yeah, just open up the vlog. Happy Sunday. Gonna go in here and chill out with them for a little bit, and I'll see y'all after a while. Several hours later, unfortunately for me, my sister did not cook as she had said that she would. So I just ran to the store to pick up my like weekly essentials. I've been kind of doing the same thing each week. It's only like $100 and that's good because I would normally run out of everything at one time and have to go to the grocery store and spend $300, and we're not doing that. So I've just been picking up like things I know I'm going to use for the week, like my salads, my rotisserie chicken. They were all out of salads. They didn't even have the small ones today, but it's okay. I did get two things of rotisserie chicken. I know you're like, why did you get two things of rotisserie chicken? But my plan is to meal prep with that. So I'm going to take the chicken, put some rice, put a vegetable, and that's going to be my lunch or dinner all week. I'm doing my shakes for breakfast. And so I'll just have to find like another meal for either lunch or dinner on the days that I don't eat the rotisserie chicken and the rice. Me, I can eat the same thing for days. Some people get tired of leftovers or can't meal prep. I can, and this is easier for me than cooking myself because I don't feel like it. So I could have just bought the chicken or thawed some chicken out, but work smarter, not harder. So rotisserie chicken be like $7, and I got two of those. And it ain't good. Don't sleep on Harris Teeter rotisserie chicken. I got it from Whole Foods one time. It wasn't it. But yeah, so I'm probably gonna eat some of that tonight since my sister did not cook. And y'all see how excited I was about that meal? And she just didn't. But maybe next Sunday. But yeah, my mom and Callie Riley are gone. So it is like 5:19 exactly. I'm about to get in here, eat something, and then get ready for the week. I still need to finish going through my drawers and stuff and inventory in my closet. This has been weeks on end that I said I'm gonna get this done, and each weekend I just don't do it. But at least I started. I got one whole drawer complete. When I came back home last night from my sister's house, I finished steaming my t-shirts and stuff. These, y'all, I showed them to you before, so freaking good. You're only supposed to eat a serving size is a fourth cup. So they're healthy for you, but not in the way that I eat them, because I be eating about half the bag. But anyway, yeah, when I came back from my sister's house last night, I did steam like all my shirts. So I got one drawer done, but it's gonna be a slow process because it's a lot. And I need a better steamer, but neither here nor there. So just checking in, I am about to, like I said, get in here, eat something. And then just wind down for the week. As my mama say, Gotta hit it in the morning. Gotta go to work in the morning, so I'm about to relax. I'm really kind of sleepy. I don't know why I've been so tired lately, but yeah, I'm going to probably call it an early night. So happy Sunday, good peeps. Say my name, say my name. You acting kind of shady. Ain't calling me baby. Why the sudden change? Say my name, say my name. If no one is around you, say baby, I love you. If you ain't running game, say my name, say my name.
Did I ever ask you to take me to go shopping in Paris or go sailing overseas and just drape me in Gucci, no? All I ever asked was you to pick up the phone when you alone. All I ever asked was you to show me some love, kisses and hugs. No, I never had an issue, go to the club with your boys, baby. I never wanted you to stay too long, just wanted you to show me up. I just want you to say my name, say my name. If you claim you want me, it ain't no time. You acting kinda shady. You ain't been calling me baby. Boy, you can go stop playing games, playing games.
So y'all, I got the camera hiked up here like this because I have my work shirt on and y'all don't even know where I work. But I'm about to get ready to make my morning smoothie, showing y'all the vitamins I take in the morning and stuff. And I hear this noise, like some water, but I was about to go put on a cardigan or something so I could continue with my video. Y'all, tell me why. Hold on. Tell me why there is... Can y'all see that? So I had to put a bucket down here. Hold on, let me make sure. It was already water on the floor. And I'm like, when I went in here, I almost slipped. Lawsuit. But it's coming from my upstairs vent. So it's like, is somebody in the bathtub and it didn't fill the bucket yet. And it sounded like it's in my shower too. Hold on. It's just in the bucket. And just on that part of the floor. I mean, they need to come get it together, because if this go into my closet, we're gonna have some real problems. So the shake is not what's important. Let me get out of here for the damn. This is some crazy, some scurry shit going on. Maintenance just came in here, right? He in the bathroom looking at it. Why he go in the bathroom? Let me just show y'all. I'm not about to stand in there, because he go in the bathroom and the whole light that was over here fell, almost hit him in the head, bust. And now more water is leaking. I don't know what is going on. I'm about to keep cursing. But look at this. What is going on up in here on this good old Monday morning? Like, and the thing is, I've been listening to my worship music. The devil, back up off me. Like, I'm just scared it's gonna mess up my clothes. I'm shaking. I'm scared it's gonna mess. Y'all just seen that. I'm just gonna have to put a little thing there. I'm scared it's gonna mess up my clothes. And my sister, I ain't know she could do, but she ain't answering the phone. Let me tell my job, I'm not about to be able to get on this call. BRB. Excuse the walls and stuff. We didn't beat these walls up. Never move clothes out of closet stuff. I still got this drawer right here. This is like my workout clothes, my bra, underwear stuff, lounge clothes. if the ceiling ended up falling through, they just gonna have to get wet. We got renter's insurance, but this, everything's out of here because we wasn't taking no chances with the ceilings. So let me get up on out of here. Because y'all, this is really almost bust his head wide open. And so they said that they, let me sit y'all down, hold on. And look at this, look at all this mess that I have to straighten up. So it's safe to say I'm not going to work. Like, I'd be looking for any excuse not to go in the office, but this one, I would've went in. I was on my way out the door. Like, I got ready so early this morning. I was listening to my praise and worship music, was getting ready to make my smoothie. And then this. So I changed clothes. Safe to say I'm not going to work. My living room looks atrocious. So they basically said they think that a valve in somebody's bathtub burst, like some type of pipe burst, and they're trying to shut off the water. I don't know if the person was like filling their tub up and the pipe burst, and I don't know, because the water's still coming out and it can't be that much water. I'm trying not to curse. It can't be that much water in somebody's bathtub. So they're trying to shut the water off. They advise that I take all my clothes out, which I was doing that anyway, but they advise that I take all my clothes out of there because if it continues to leak, like how that light fixture burst, like if it goes that way, it'll ruin all the clothes in my closet, and we ain't got time for that, because even with renter's insurance, I want my stuff. Like, I want the stuff that I have. So this is fine. And I'm trying not to be bummed about it, because I was just telling my sister, like, God, him and his sense of humor, it be a little dark sometimes, because I have been saying I want to go through my closet. Y'all know I just did my one drawer in my dresser in my room. I've been wanting to go through my closet, inventory my clothes, but I want to do it on my time. I wanted to do it slowly. He was like, nah, you getting rid of some stuff. Like, so all my clothes are in the living room now. I would be a fool to not inventory them before I put them back in the closet. So that's what we're gonna work on. And I can't live like this. I can't live with junk everywhere in my clothes like this. So it's gonna get done quick, fast, and a hurry, probably today. Because I just can't. Lesson here, though, it's a lesson in everything. Be a minimalist, because this looked like a lot of stuff, but I was able to take everything out of my closet in like 15 minutes. If that, I was moving so fast. If I had a whole bunch of junk, like a whole bunch of stuff, like just everywhere, it would be no way. So in a case of emergency, you trying to save your things, don't hold on to stuff. Like, that has no value, has no meaning, like it has no like reason. You have no reason to have it. I called my mama, because my mama, we ain't gonna put her business out there, but she got a lot of stuff. She got a lot of stuff, and she has a shopping problem, and she bought a whole bunch of stuff. There'd been no way that she would have been able to get her stuff out. Like, if it do decide to go, which hopefully they are able to contain it, but if it do decide to go in my closet, there would have been no way that she would have been able to get all her stuff out. So while I'm thankful that it's condensed enough that I was able to do that, I'm about to condense it even more. Like, yeah, a lesson. It's a lesson. And then the other lesson is, do what you said you was gonna do when you said you was gonna do it. Heard you. Here, I haven't even touched my clothes yet, but they've had, let me see if we can see it, some, like, they're on the ceiling with this, like, if y'all don't know if you guys see it, this pipe or the apartment above my, I don't know, up there, it says the cleaner. My carpet cleaner. So somebody apparently above me, they must have carpet. Thanks the Lord I don't have carpet. The apartment above me, their carpet must have got damaged. Lord, I'm thankful that I was still here. Their carpet must have gotten damaged, and that carpet cleaner is up there, like, probably drying their carpet. Do you know how stink that probably is? Because the water is not clear. So I don't know if it was rusty pipe water, if it was somebody's dirty bathtub water. I don't know what kind of water it was. It's kind of gross. So every time I touch that bucket or go to, like, get anything up, I'm washing my hands, because that is disgusting. I don't know what kind of water it is. But, yeah, this has been an eventful morning. So they'll be back in here, in and out, you know, just making sure. But those water spots are actually getting worse. So I think water is just sitting. So I'm just going to stay out of there. I'm thankful my clothes were out. It could always be worse. Had I not left, I mean, had I left, had I already left and not gone back in the bathroom, it would have just been a disaster when I came home. So I'm just so, so thankful I hadn't left work yet. Like, left for work yet. Yeah, I'm just at a loss for words at this point. I'm really not, like, tripping about it, though, because none of my stuff is damaged. I want to go through the stuff anyway, and the repairs are on them. So I'm not tripping, but I got a lot of work to do. So just want to give y'all an update. Okay, so Kendra has come to assist. She's the style expert. Anyway, I've been wanting to do this anyway. So God has forced us to do what we said we was going to do. She is coming to help me make sense of what I have. Yeah. We're going to get rid of some stuff, which, like I said, I'm glad that I don't have a whole bunch of stuff because I was able to, in record time, move all this stuff out of here. But, yep, we're going to get to it, see what we can do, what we can get rid of. This is where we are right now. They're cutting holes for like ventilation where the water damage was. They're coming, they're gonna have to redo, drill some holes. Oh, they already drilled the holes in the baseboard so that can air out. They have that, they've taken off that right there, which it looked like it needed to be replaced anyway. Yeah. So I'm not gonna be staying in my apartment for a few days because I'm not staying with stuff like this because what if a rat or something come out? Oh no.
You a bad girl and your friends bad too. Oh, you got the swag sauce, you drippin' swag goo. You a bad girl and your friends bad too. Oh, you got the swag sauce, you drippin' swag goo. Oh,
I may be young, but I'm ready.
So it's been today's Saturday, you know, my disaster happened on Monday, so it's been quite a few days, but we are back. So here is the update. I'm going to go in the bathroom and show you what we got going on. Hold on, I don't know what my camera's doing. Okay, so this is where the water was leaking from. This was a vent. They still have to come back and, you know, make that look better and put the vent lid back on. And then they had cut out some holes here. This is like where the AC unit or something is, he told me. I don't know, I've always hated that, but this apartment is old, whatever. Anyway, there were some holes here. They patched those up. And this is where the light fixture is supposed to be. They actually have a box on my counter. I guess that's the light is gonna go there. Or the light that they have to replace the one that broke is gonna go. But yeah, so it's livable. Cause they had told me I could come back like day before yesterday, but it was still holes in the ceiling. And when I came yesterday to check, cause I've been coming to check every day. When I came yesterday to check, everything was covered in plastic and it just was not, it would have been uncomfortable. So thankfully I did have my sister's place to go to, and that's where I've been all week. But I think I'm gonna come back today. I just brought my stuff to like wash my clothes and just check on it. But since it's basically fixed, it just has to put the vents back on. I'm gonna go ahead and get in here because I have so much to do. Like, remember I took everything out my closet, so I really have to put everything back in my closet. But before I do that, I want to like clean my closet out. And then they left it kind of messy in here. It's like dusty, and from where they were painting, it's like, you know, just like, I don't know if it's paint dust or what, but I have to get in there and clean my tub out, clean my bathroom real good. I'm gonna sweep, I'm gonna mop it here, because people have been in and out my apartment all week. That makes me cringe a little bit. Like, not a little bit, it makes me cringe a lot of it. So I'm about to get in here and really clean up, wash some clothes, like I said, clean out my closet, because everything's out. I'm gonna take time to do that before I put my clothes back in there, because my clothes are all, even if I want to come here and just get in my bed, because you know it's like nothing like getting your bed. If I wanted to come here, you know, Lord have mercy. Mermaid never look like this. It's stuff everywhere. Like, so it's organized though, because me and my sister went through. So like, these are my jeans. I got like my orange stuff over here because I broke it up by color and stuff. So it is organized. It's just like a lot of it on my bed, and I really wouldn't mind getting in the bed, but that's not gonna happen right now. So I'm about to get in here and clean up, probably put some music on, clean up and get to it. This is gonna be my weekend. If y'all see all these are shoes on the counter, it's just, it's a mess. But I can't live like this. So I'm about to get in here, clean up, get it together. Yeah, happy Saturday. That's the update. Just want to fill y'all in, because that was crazy, wasn't it? Like, I'm so glad I was here though, because it could have been so much worse. Like, there's a silver lining and everything. Like, I was here able to catch mine, because some people had real damage. I was able to catch mine, contain it, get all my clothes. And then the fact that I've been wanting to go through my clothes anyway, I was just forced to. So now I can hang my stuff up all nice. Like, it was a silver lining, but it was unexpected. So kind of threw me for a loop, knocked me off my workout plan. You know, I had just got back in the gym. Y'all saw last vlog, I'm in the gym. Like, but it's okay. It's okay. We live to fight another day. So that's how we are. Hey y'all, so I know this vlog has probably been very boring. I haven't done much of anything other than worry about this apartment. That happened earlier this week. It was at my sister's house all week. It was really nothing to vlog. We did go see Dave Chappelle on Thursday, but I don't know if you guys know, Dave Chappelle was kind of like, it's like the Kevin Hart show. You have to put your phones in pouches. So you can't vlog, you can't take pictures, you can't be on your phone for the entire show. So got nothing there. We did have girls' night at Ebony, shout out to Eb. Seafood night, I got a little bit of that footage. But other than that, literally, I'm going to work, going to my sister's house, going to bed. So I'm finally back home. Yesterday I showed you guys the update of repairs. They still haven't come to do that. I guess they'll do that tomorrow, since it is Sunday. They'll come back and do that tomorrow. But I've just been in here cleaning. I cleaned up my bathroom real good. I just mopped and all that. And now I'm about to get in here and actually start putting stuff back. Everything is still on my bed how it was, but my closet is fully cleaned out, dusted, mopped, whatever, swept. And now I'm about to hang things up. So I'm going to show you guys that. I'll fast forward it, of course. But that's where we are on this good old Sunday evening. We're about to get that so I can sleep in my bed tonight. I slept on the couch last night, which the couch felt good. Like, my couch was comfy. I was knocked down. So no complaints to the couch. Got up, went to church this morning, went to brunch, and now we're back in our PJs, comfy and cozy in our PJs, and we're about to knock this closet out so I can be comfy and cozy in my bed tonight. So that's what we're doing. Okay,
So we're in the closet now, about to bring stuff in. Don't mind this mirror. I know y'all been seeing this in clips. My bedroom set is old as Bethesda. And so she's not getting moved to another place. Whether I buy a house, go to another apartment, she's not getting moved because she's old. I've had her for like 10 plus years. She was the first bed set I got, you know, whatever. But this mirror is supposed to go on my dresser, but I don't use it because I have my TV up there and stuff. So she's just been tucked away in the closet where she will remain tucked away until it's time to throw her out. But you won't see it when I hang my clothes back up. But just in case y'all like, why she got that mirror in her closet? That's fine. Done with that closet, thank the Lord. I am so excited to sleep in my bed tonight because I really wanted to do it last night, y'all, but I looked at that pile on my bed and was like, yeah, I'm sleeping on the couch, and I slept good. But I'm so excited to sleep in my bed tonight. I'm about to get in the shower. I know I got pajamas on, but I done had these on all day. I'm about to get in the shower and sleep so good. And my bed is clean in here, my clothes are all situated, I cleaned up my living room, kitchen, all that. Like, I feel back to normal. We're gonna see what this Monday entails. We're gonna pray that it ain't nothing crazy. Hey girl, hey. So last and final update for the water episode. Y'all saw last night that I finished my closet and I cleaned up my bathroom real good. I'm so happy that I got everything done last night because unbeknownst to me, I knew they were coming back in here today to fix the light fixture, which they put that little light up there. They put the vent back on. And I knew they were coming to do that, and I figured they were gonna wipe down. Do y'all know that they did a full deep cleaning of my entire apartment? I'm talking about baseboards and windows and blinds and, I mean, the whole nine. And so I was like, oh, I'll take it, because not only did none of my stuff get damaged and I was not responsible for repairs, I wanted to go through my things anyway. So it gave me time to organize my closet. Again, my closet is so nice and organized right now. It gave me time to organize my closet again. And they literally came in here. They were here for like 3 hours this morning. Cleaning. Like, I'm going to turn the camera around and show. I mean, the bathroom is pretty self-explanatory. You can't really see. That light is so bright compared to what I had. But they cleaned my bathtub again, cleaned my toilet, cleaned the sink, which I had already done. They mopped in here. They cleaned my bedroom. They such a good job, like, cleaning up. I mean, they took my cushions out of my couch. They vacuumed inside of my couch. I mean, they just did the whole nine. Like, it is so clean. It smells so clean in here. Got my candles going. Like, my place is so cozy and so clean right now. Like, despite that. And I'm happy. I'm not happy there was water damage, but it was a blessing in it for me. So, yeah. So be it. So yeah, today, ended up working from home. That was not by choice. I was about to get up and get ready for work, and they came in here, and they was here for 3 hours, like, in my bathroom, and I couldn't, like, I already felt awkward that I was in their way, so I couldn't get ready for work. So we're working from home today. Probably about to get some lunch in a second, but I just wanted to give you the final update of the water fiasco here at Damo's residence. I think that's it. I think that's all this vlog has been. Like I said, I didn't do much this last week because I wasn't home, and when I did go to Dave Chappelle, you couldn't record. And so, I mean, it's just not much in this vlog, but I apologize. Next vlog will be a little bit better. I guess I may be closing this out now. I don't know how much footage I have. I'm gonna take a look and see, but yeah, I may be closing it out soon just because, I mean, there wasn't much going on. There wasn't much going on other than, you know, trying to figure out what's going on with my place where I lay my head. So,
hey girl. So today is Wednesday, November 1st. Happy November. It's a new month. Y'all, it's really the end of the year. Like, it's not even, I mean, it's the end of the year. We got Thanksgiving coming up, Christmas, New Year's, my birthday. Like, the year's over. Happy 2024. But anyway, I just got in and I was putting some things away and I'm like, I can show them this because this vlog has been kind of wiggity whack. So I'll show you. I went to Trader Joe's and so I've been seeing some skincare stuff. Y'all know I love skincare and I'm not going to use all this at one time because I don't want my face to start breaking out and I don't know the source of the breakout, but I have seen stuff on TikTok about Trader Joe's skincare. And so first up is this vitamin C firming body butter made with glycolic acid, and it has a clementine scent. I don't know if you've seen this on, is that focus? Yeah. But this is really good for like textured skin. And if you want to even out your skin tone, I've seen a really good things about this. Glycolic acid helps with like breakouts and anything like that. So if you have like back knee or if like your, like, you know how to like the back of your legs or the back of your thighs are sometimes a little rougher than like the rest of your legs, this is good for that. So I'm going to try her out. Won't use it on my face, but like when you get out the shower, put this on. But before that, I also, I know you guys have seen this. This vitamin E oil is supposed to be really good too for even out your skin tones. As smooth onto face, hands, legs, feet as needed. Also maybe poured into the bath as desired for a soft, silky feel. Excellent moisturizer for all skin types. So it's getting cold outside. Charlotte? Oh, October said, I'm out of here, but I'm going to leave y'all with something. It's freezing. It ain't fall. It's winter. It's cold. So, baby, you got to up on the moisturizer. We want to be moisturized. You know, like, you know how I say a glazed donut on the face? I want to be glazy all over. This is going to do it. This is going to do it. $3.99. This was $6.99. And Sephora has one by Skin Fix. I think it's like $30 or $40, I'll take $6.99. And then lastly from Trader Joe's, as far as skin, I got this pumpkin overnight face mask. It says to use this, apply a generous layer as the final step in your nighttime skin routine. Pat until product is moistly absorbed. And then it says, wash face thoroughly, put an awakening. I've seen good things about this as well. To brighten your skin tone, to make you super moisturized. Like, I don't know if y'all know, but I gotta find my tripod. This is hurting my arm. Jesus. But like when you do your skincare in the morning, at night, you do your skincare at night and then you wake up looking all like plump and moisturized in the morning. This is what this is gonna do for you. It's a pumpkin mask with enzyme. Battery died as usual, but yeah. The pumpkin overnight face mask, seen this on TikTok as well, and I'm super excited to try that. Also from Trader Joe's, my sister has been raving about these. These are the cinnamon roll grizzled. What is wrong with me talking? Cinnamon roll, or reading rather, but like, how you don't know how to read? Let me prop y'all up on something because we ain't about to just hurt my arms like that. Jesus Christ. These are the cinnamon roll drizzled granola. And so what her logic was to put these in some yogurt as like a little snack, but Blake, my niece, has been effing them up. Like, she will really make you want to try something. She need to do her own mukbang because she be eating these and I be on FaceTime with them. I'm like, dang, I kind of want to try some of them because she make them look so good. But yeah, I got two of these because I like granola, I like cinnamon rolls, I like yogurt, so that just sounds like a great combination. What I've already put up is these two things. So I think I've showed these before. This beef birra, I think that's how you say it, whatever, y'all seen that on TikTok as well. Those tacos, Trader Joe's sells this and you have to, you know, put your own onions and all that in there, but this is just the meat and the gravy. I put it over rice a lot of times and it's like a stew beef. It's really good.
And then my sister suggested this cabbage. She said that this cabbage is really good. Sorry, that light. I'm got my light on because the sun's going down, so it's dark in here. But this cabbage is supposed to be really good. So she even said that she put this with this and some rice together, and it was like that. So we're gonna try it. Got way too much stuff in the freezer right now, but that's a blessing. Yeah, so that was it for Trader Joe's. Now, some of my stuff came in from Sephora. I'm still waiting on one package, and there's like little stuff that I want to order, but I really don't need nothing else. But I showed you guys what I got, what I picked up from the store the other day, so I'm gonna show you what came in the mail. And yeah, Sephora. I love Sephora, y'all. Like, I truly do. It's so much good stuff. I need to order me a box opener because that ain't safe. They got this thing stuffed. All my products gotta be in here. So, another mask. I've heard about this for years, never tried it, but Jerenica Masia, I think that's how you say her name. They call her G. Let me lift it up because that's bugging me. Jerenica Masia, yes, yeah, she was saying how anytime she uses this, any texture, under the skin bumps, like blemishes, unevenness that she has on her face, it wipes it out, and you can only get this online. So this is the Irish Moor Mud Mask, Purifying Black Mask from Peter Thomas Roth. Peter Thomas Roth makes great products. I have several of their products. I have, I've used their moisturizer, I've used cleanser, I use eye patches. Really good brand, so I'm excited to try that. Also, I have topicals. I've used this before. This is very good for dark marks. Like, so if you've noticed, I have dark marks right here, discoloration around here from where I like, I have a really bad habit of doing this, like chewing my cheek. So it has discoloration here, and this is just from like post acne marks. And I do use this, the medical grade skincare products that I told y'all about a few vlogs back, but I'm running out of stuff, and these are just like staples in my skincare. So, and they're much cheaper. I ain't gonna say they're cheap, but they're much cheaper than re-upping on that medical grade, because that stuff, you go through skincare fast, me, because I do it religiously. So I don't know how often I'm gonna be buying that. And like, I use my FSA when I bought it before, but the last time I tried to get some, my FSA didn't work. So yeah, bro, let me stick to what I know and what is affordable for me. But yeah, topicals is very good for fading dark marks and things like that. So it's brightening and clearing serum. Got her back on deck. This really hurts my arm. Jesus. But I don't like that bright light on the packaging like that. These, I wanted the bigger version, but I was being cheap and didn't want to spend the money on perfume. These were $80. I mean, it was a couple dollars off because of the sale, but I think I'm going to return one or the other and get the bigger version because I love both of these. So I love Autumn Vibes. Autumn Vibes is my jam for the winter. I got onto this last winter. For the fall, winter, it is so warm. It is so sexy. It is so rich and expensive smelling. You smell like, who is that woman? Oh, she just smells so good. Like, Autumn Vibes was a great name for it because it's like very moody, very vibey. The fragrance description on here is woody trail and red leaves. I don't know if I would say that. But it's very, very much mysterious, sexy. And then my mama actually put me onto this one. This is Coffee Break, another fall winter scent. She was wearing this when we went to Vegas, and I'm like, I like that. And then them two together, oh, she gonna be smelling very fall vibes, very sexy, very warm, very grown. So I'm excited about mixing those together. Yeah, my arm is hurting again. Excited about mixing those together, but I think I might get the bigger size of Autumn Vibes because I know that's my personal like scent. Like, I love that one. I haven't worn Coffee Break. I've smelled it on her.
So I'm going to wear it, see how I like it on my scent. Because that's one thing about perfume. I don't necessarily gatekeep my perfume because it ain't going to smell the way it smells on you and me. And that's just tea. Like, your perfume has to match your body chemistry. And just because something smells good on you don't mean it's going to smell good on me. It's because it smells good on me don't mean it's going to smell good on you. So perfume is not something I got blind by just because somebody say it smelled good like that Beyonce. Y'all tripping. Because heat didn't smell that good, if we want to be honest. Beehive don't come for me. But yeah, I'm interested to see what it smells like. But I wouldn't buy, and especially like $100 perfume, $168, something like that. I'm not buying that without smelling it. So perfume I don't gatekeep, because you might like, I mean, it might smell good on you and buy it. I mean, they don't make perfume just for one person. I will say it's weird if somebody that you're with all the time buys the same perfume as you, is because it's like, why we need to smell exactly alike? You know what I mean? Like, but if you just, your friend that y'all go out to eat sometimes together, whatever, like, just get the perfume. You think it smells good? Anyway, I'm going on a tangent. But my last thing that I got from Sephora to show y'all today is this, let me see if it's going to focus. Shani Darden At Home Triple Acid Signature Peel. It's a resurfaced brighten refine. It's a 3 peels in it, and it's 8 treatments of exfoliating peel solution. I think you only do this like once a month. This was expensive. Now, this was probably the most expensive thing that I bought so far in the Sephora, during the Sephora sale, but I've been wanting this for a while. So since it was 20% off, 20% ain't, you know, dang, where I'm not focusing. 20% ain't a whole lot, but it's better than 0%. So I decided now is the time to get it. I follow Kyra Amanique on YouTube. She swears by this. She's a skincare girly as well. And she's like, for brightening your skin, removing those dark marks. I really want to go get me a facial, but this is a good at-home solution if esthetician or getting a facial isn't in the cards for you right now. This is something good to try. So I think I'm going to try this this week, and maybe the mud mask next week, like, you know, space some of this stuff out. But I, you know, I'm a skincare person, so I want to try stuff. I want to see what works without, you know, stressing my skin out. So I will be reporting back to you guys, letting you know what I like, what I didn't like. But I'm really excited about all the stuff that I have, because it all has great reviews. But again, just because something works for somebody else doesn't mean it's going to work for you and your skin. I don't have super sensitive skin, so I'm not too concerned about it like breaking me out and stuff. But again, I don't want to just overhaul and do too much to my skin at one time and it'd be like, hold on, girl, you tripping. So again, this is the Shani Darden, black woman. It's not focusing, is it? Yeah, there we go. Again, triple acid signature peel. So I am excited about that. And that is, yeah, the things that I got from Sephora. The only other things that I'm waiting on that I probably won't show you guys, that it comes tomorrow, is I have a lip gloss moisturizer from Winnie Harlow's line. I thought that would be really good. It looks really moisturizing. I have that, and then I have the Fenty body butter. There's a cinnamon fragrance that's only for this season. It's seasonal, so I got 2 of those because I got them last year, and they really do smell really good. Like, smells very edible, and we likes that. So I got 2 of those and that lip moisturizer, and that's it. The other stuff that I have in my cart right now on Sephora that I don't know if I'm gonna pull the trigger on are some Sephora collection makeup brushes, because you get 30% off of those if you're Rouge until November 6th, and I'm Rouge. So I'm like, well, this is a great time to get makeup brushes. And the Sephora collection makeup is very cheap and it's great. So there's some blushes that I want. But I don't wear blush that much. So they're normally $14. So with 30% off, you do the math, that's a good deal. So I might get those. I don't know. That's what's in my cart right now, though. Ooh, that was hurting my arm, but y'all crooked. My camera, don't you fall, because we ain't buying another one. Yeah, that'll do for now, I think. What y'all think? I don't know when my tripod is, but this is hurting my arm. Anyway, let me show you what I got from Amazon. This every vlog, I'm gonna be doing some sort of unboxing. Like, I used to never shop online. Now it is just like, girl, every week. I'm about to cut it out though, because I got stuff. I got goals. Okay, so this is a external hard drive. My computer is definitely running out of spaces making these vlogs. I have so much video footage, some that don't even make the vlog, and I upload it all onto my computer, and my computer like, hey girl, we won't got enough space for that. So I'll have this link below which one I ordered, but I thought it was gonna tell me like how much storage is on it. I think it's like a terabyte or something. I don't know, don't get me the line, but it's a lot because this shit was $60. So it's a lot, and I'm gonna take all the footage that I have on my computer and stuff and put it onto here. That way that my computer still has storage, and I have this. It's portable, I can always have it. If something happens to my computer, I don't lose my footage and I don't have to delete footage. Because some videos I be wanting to keep, like, okay, yeah, they're in the vlog, but I don't necessarily want to delete them. Like Poo Poo's birthday, I want to have all that footage for when she gets older and stuff, and not just on the vlog. Because what if YouTube goes away one day, like, you know, like my space. So yeah, that's gonna help me with that. That's gonna be my project over the next however long. You already know the vibes, clean skin towelettes. But here's the thing, these are the bamboo ones. We getting fancy. So I use these all the time. I've talked about these in several vlogs, but I wanted to see what the bamboo was talking about. Dry your face after cleansing, pair with makeup remover to gently and effortlessly remove makeup, wet and remove face mask, it's mess free. I mean, they do all the same things the other ones do. I just want to see if I like these better. I don't know, bamboo just gives me vacation vibes. So I got two of those because I run out of them quickly. I wash my face sometimes several times a day, definitely twice a day. But sometimes if I wore makeup and I want to change my makeup throughout the day, I don't know, y'all. I just wash my face sometimes and a lot in a day, and I need those on deck. Never want to run out of those. These. I ain't had these in a while. My life been a little stressful, and I'm thinking I should have read up on a long time ago. These are the ashwagandha gummies. They relax, restore, and unwind. They do just that. You take two in the morning, two at night, or take them as needed. I don't smoke weed. I can't. But these, they gonna make you say, you know what? Whatever. That's what they do. They are like a, I guess, type thing. And I need that in my life right now. So ashwagandha. I get mine off of Amazon, but you can get them from Target, CVS, wherever. A lot of times I go to Target, they are out of stock. Something else I don't need to run out of, because life be lifing and those be helping. And last but not least for this impromptu unboxing is the Snail Mucin. This, of course, another skincare product. I think I'm gonna do a TikTok, because I'm not lying when I say people been asking me when I buy from Sephora and stuff, or get the skincare routine, even though I did put it in a vlog. The people want to see. There have been like four people asked. So yeah, but Snail Mucin, I've shown this before. It's viral, it's been all over TikTok, Instagram. It is very good for keeping your skin hydrated. I put this on after I tone my skin. So I wash my face, I tone it. And then I'll typically, if I have this, put this on. I've been out for like a month or so. I don't know why I didn't reorder it, but it's very good for keeping your skin hydrated. And you want to keep your skin hydrated in these cooler months, as well as if you use like retinols or things like that. On your skin, those are very drying to your skin. You want to make sure that like you are keeping your skin barrier protected with moisture. So on top of using your normal moisturizer and like serums that target different things, you want something that just keeps it hydrated. And this also, not only does it hydrate your skin, it plumps your skin. Like you be able to like, and your skin bounce back. So she's good. We like her. Take a screenshot. Again, I'll have all this stuff linked. The Trader Joe's stuff. I don't think you can link Trader Joe's stuff, so y'all better take a screenshot if y'all didn't. Screenshot this is the body lotion,
body butter. And I know I said I got the Fenty one. You can never have too much body butter. I mean, who want to be ashy and dusty? This is the pumpkin face mask. I will keep y'all posted on how I like it. This is the vitamin E oil. Check it out when you're in Trader Joe's. Trader Joe's is cheap. Like, everything off of Amazon I'll have links. Everything off Sephora I'll have linked. But yeah, we're about dinner and call it a night. I've been trying to, this week is new for me, wake up at 6:30. In between that time, do my devotionals, like read the Bible. I have a woman's Bible that kind of guides you through what to read, and like has a devotional attached to it. So I've been trying to do that, and then go to the gym. But that means I have to go to bed early. So it is like 5:49. I'm about to clean this mess up and then eat, chill out for maybe like another hour or two, and then get ready for bed, because one thing we're not gonna skimp out on is sleep. So if I'm getting up earlier, that means I gotta go to bed earlier. It's about to start getting dark earlier anyway. Might as well. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this little unboxing. I did. I love new stuff. Like, even though that mean I spent money, I love it. Hey girl, hey, just wanted to get on here and officially close out this vlog. This was a vlog full of the water fiasco and impromptu unboxing. So I hope you enjoyed it. It was a little bit different, but I hope you enjoyed it. If you made it this far, I truly appreciate you for your support and tuning in. We're gonna keep it up, keep the ball rolling. So thank you so much for your support. I hope you continue to watch and make sure you subscribe. Our goal now is 500 subscribers, still very, very new here. So we're trying to get to 500 subscribers. So make sure you're telling a friend to tell a friend, if they like my content, what I'm putting out, to subscribe, like, share, comment, all that good stuff. I'll have everything linked in the description box below about what I bought if you're interested in any of that stuff. And until next time, I'm sure we'll have another unboxing in the next video as well. So I'll talk to y'all later. Thanks again.